Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Dear men, dear MGTOW, kindly find in several parts this day a bit of information from a website form goingyourownway.com. This time it is about MGTOW awareness of the actual nature of women, part 2. Though women was always opportunistic, traditionalism encouraged her to see the long view, to know that life was about give and take. The erosion of traditionalism meant women defaulted to primitive instinct. In this world, BRIFO law is ever more important. In short, all man is good for is what he can do for her today. His past actions does and accrue to the present. Men did not need traditionalism to retain future orientation. The understanding that relationships are built over time, to reciprocate over the long term. Women did. Without it, women are almost inhumanly opportunistic. It is a mindset that may have been fitting during the Paleolithic era, but not now and certainly not the basis for a relationship. A long-term relationship cannot be built on a woman jungle mindset. The broken woman guide to dating. Because a woman claims she has been played so often she knowingly chased bad boys who wouldn't commit. She takes it out on 80% RS she dates later on. She makes them wait for sex. I want to get to know you better, it's special so it can wait, you e not one of those guys. It may not be the 90 days of think like a man but it can go on date after date after date. Why? Because it's a shit test to see if you e a thirsty beta male. If you wait, you pass the test. A woman in some ways is using her sexuality against the man in a kind of delayed revenge against the men who lured her via tingles. The 80% R gets the payback, blue balls, and becomes the spreadsheet husband. Insecurely raids his cell phone because she been hurt before, wants to know which girls he spends time with, cuts off friendships with single male friends, and more, all an overcompensation for her relationship failures with more prolific men before. The entitlement of the modern woman means that her world. The modern woman gets the full princess treatment from society. She is a faultless angel. She can be anything she wants whereas young boys are scolded by largely female teachers growing up. An elite-funded media knowingly tips the scales in favor of women to create an adversarialism between men and women. Further, the sexual imbalance created by the majority of the women pursuing the same few men, means that the remaining men must tolerate a woman-entitled mindset, or else. Women are simply not that interested in what a man wants from life. It her agenda, her friends. Chris Rock take on the modern woman is accurate, and the focus is all about her. It's all about her. She's already there, fellas, she's waiting for you to come aboard. Fellas, when you wake up in the morning, you should look yourself in the mirror and say, fuck you. Fuck your hopes, fuck your dreams, fuck your plans. Let go out there and try to make this bitch happy. Almost every guy in a relationship can attest to the fact that women try to take you away from your friends. After play acting they like your hobbies try to ridicule you for them so you spend less time on them. Her whole life, society put her first. And she not about to be second anytime soon. The traits of entitlement have various aspects, egocentrism, solipsism, rationalization, and narcissism, none of which are pleasant. Men don't want a competing agenda. They want someone who willing to compromise. There has to be give and take. The bitchy behavior of women ready to settle. You cannot go on a date with a woman who's a late 20-something or older and not realize it. They are angry, bitter. They have what's called a primacal, forever frowning and seething. Sometimes it's called resting bitch face or a bitch shield. On a date, they will demand to be provided for, quiz the man on whether he can cook for her, what kind of car he has. It's not an honest inquiry into his lifestyle, but a brutal and demanding and angry set of questions as though he himself is nothing without his capacity and willingness to support her in one way or another. Where does this come from? Two places. First, modern society has imbued in women unrealistic expectations of having it all, but they have not mentioned to her that everything in this world takes work. She expected the C-suite position in corporate America by virtue of equality in gender outcomes between men and women but never earned it. She left work at 4:50 p.m. to do happy hour with her friends and the plum position never came. So too did Hollywood tell her that she was special, A princess and Prince Charming would waltz into her life. Her early 20s, the height of her sexual desirability, saw man after man proposition her. Never did she think she would have to cultivate the kind of personality that would make a man want to stay. And none did. She spent her life worshipping alphas, and now has to settle for an 80% man, and she is not happy about it, or where she is in life in general. Assuming and not working towards lofty expectations will do that to you. The second reason is relationship failure. The cumulative psychological toll of being fucked and chucked by dozens of men has left a permanent sense of bitterness against men. Whereas a woman's subconscious instinct has been programmed over millennia to never lash out against alphas for fear of consequence, she feels she can comfortably displace her anger at being discarded by men over and again, even though it was by a different set of men on the new 80% man she meets. He will have to pay for the fact that some guy banged her at a house party, and then walked out the door, never to return her texts. The average guy does not want to have the bitterness of 100 pump and dumps that a woman endured displaced onto him as a reward for being the one man in her life that may be interested in her long term. Ridiculous selection criteria. Ever notice how women used to pick gentlemen, and now almost all of them want bad boys, players? Ever notice how a fair number of these guys are douches or guys going nowhere in life? None of this is by accident. This is a result of the Great Regression. It is women choosing based on primitive instinct hypergamy, valuing social and physical dominance, rather than the actual value of a man or long-term compatibility. Upper bicep tattoo, good. Steady, well, paying job like accountant, bad as it's boring. Mysterious, criminal past, good. Decent, respectful man, bad as it's boring. The modern man is walking through a world that has been flipped on its head. In most cases, actual value is inversely proportional to sexual market value. Women are unknowingly pursuing men with traits that would advantage them in 30,000 BC. Most men don't want to live down to that standard today. If attracting women means being something men don't want to be, they may simply pass.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.